By now, we know how sexual reproduction in plants takes place. This is what we've learned. The flower, which is the reproductive organ of the plant, bears the male and the female parts. The male part, the stamen, contains the male gamete, while the female part, the pistil, has the female gamete. Fusion of the two gives rise to an embryo. Now let's get to know how exactly the process occurs. Let's learn about it in detail. But before that, tell me one thing. Do all flowers always possess both the floral parts together? Some of them do. What do we call the types of flowers which possess both the male and the female floral parts together? Flowers which contain both stamen and pistil together are called bisexual flowers. Can you name a few examples of such types? Rose, China rose are a few in this category. What about other flowers then? Don't they contain both the male and the female floral parts together? Some flowers, such as those of gourd and pumpkin, possess either stamen or pistil. That is the reason why such flowers are called unisexual flowers. Now, getting back to the process, the first step is that of pollination. It is the process by which pollen grains are transferred to the female reproductive organs of a plant. In other words, pollen from the anther are transferred to the stigma. Does this process occur only between two flowers of the same type? Yes, that is correct. Pollination occurs between the flowers belonging to the same type. And does that mean pollination occurs only between two flowers born on the same plant? That question leads us to the types of pollination. The type in which pollination occurs between flowers born on the same plant is called as self-pollination. So what will the next type be? The other type of pollination is called cross-pollination, where the pollens travel from the anther to the stigma of a different flower on another plant. Can you guess how this process of transfer of pollen grains occurs? For this, there are several agents which aid the process. Agents such as wind and water are the abiotic ones. On the other hand, biotic pollinators such as bees, bats, moths, and birds also help in the process. The process of pollination makes sure that the pollen grain safely lands on the stigma. But what happens next? Does this lead to fertilization directly? Or are there any intermediate steps? We will answer all these questions in the next video.